Well, I figured the idiotic hoax-tards would come up with lame excuses. The worst is this complete nutcase named Winston Smith 00. They're not really worth bothering with that much, but I thought I'd make a follow-up video talking in more detail about the concept used to create the simulation. It's a technique called photogrammetry, and it's as old as photography itself. First, some basic trigonometry. If you have two objects that are the same height, but one appears to be half the height of the other, then that object is twice as far away from you as the first one. All the time, every time. There really is no way around it. Only at that distance will the first object appear half the size. Photogrammetry means using these principles of trigonometry to create a real-world construction of the scene. It works best when you have photographs or videos from two or more angles. Then, all you need to know is one real-world distance measurement to recreate the entire scene full size. I didn't have the luxury of a second camera angle, but I did have the advantage of having two distance measurements, the width and the height of the flag. This is all I need to determine where to place the camera. The astronaut does not matter at this point. The ground, despite what one nutcase claimed, does not matter at all. But the hoaxtards are trying to claim that the lens matters. Well, it doesn't. There's absolutely nothing a lens can do to change the basic trigonometry mentioned earlier. Consider this following demonstration. Here, I've arranged three chairs a certain way. They won't be moved, so it really doesn't matter if we consider them one object or three. But notice that I've arranged the legs on the front two chairs so they are obscuring the front legs on the chair further away. So how do we change the perspective of this scene? The answer? Only by moving the camera, which I will now do. I'll do a dolly forward, and this might be shaky since I don't have an actual camera dolly, but here you can see that the front legs of the back chair will now be visible. Now the chairs haven't moved, so this can only happen with a perspective shift. Now you've seen this effect in movies, the push-in while zooming-out technique pioneered by Alfred Hitchcock, and in my opinion it's become way too overused, but now I'll pull the camera back and you can watch the front legs of the chair get obscured again. Now the hoaxtards are saying that you can put a wide-angle lens on the camera and achieve this same perspective shift as you can by dollying the camera in. Well, I've got a wide-angle lens right here. So let's put it on the camera and see what we get. And I'll do this without editing so they can't accuse me of any shenanigans. So here I have the camera in exactly the same position with a wide-angle lens, but as you can see, the legs on the chair are still obscured. Of course they are! In order for a lens to change perspective without changing camera position, it would have to be able to see behind objects. This is clearly stupid. The reason why photographs and videos shot with a wide-angle lens have such a different perspective is because the photographer or the director used the lens to let them get closer into the shot and still keep everything in frame the way they want it. This is the whole point of a wide-angle lens. If you're shooting from the same position and zooming to the same field of view, the perspective will be exactly the same. Winston Smith 00 claims he got this perspective change without changing the position of the camera. What he is saying contravenes basic trigonometry. It's 100% clear now that he is a liar.